What's up, internet? My name's Nerdy, and we have another Resident Evil trailer, because this thing's coming out in just barely over a month here. They are throwing these trailers out fast, and I'm excited to dive into this one, because I actually liked the first two quite a bit. I think there was one that I liked more than the other. I can't remember which it was. But they dropped them, like, on the same day, and they were both good and different and provided a, like, new world for Resident Evil to live in visually. I think that Resident Evil live action struggles at times when they try and lean too much into the game lore, because the games are just some of the best horror games ever made, and it's really hard to compare yourself to these things that are so successful. And so I think the Resident Evil series breaking out and doing its own thing a little bit, sticking close to kind of the basics of the world, but telling a different story so that it's not as easily compared to these generationally beloved massive hits, is actually really smart for Netflix to do. So let's dive into another trailer for this. I'm excited to see where they're going with this series. Boom. Netflix.
They said the world would end in 2036.
Except everyone's canceling their subscription.
But they were wrong. The world ended a long time ago. Umbrella, a company besieged by scandal, is now trying to reinvent itself.
Scandal? Killed a lot of people.
The old Umbrella made mistakes. The things we're working on today, they're gonna change the world.
That's what you said last time. What?
We have a problem. The drug contains the T-virus. The T-virus can make monsters.
Billions will die.
What?
Everyone keep your mouth shut.
Cool, that's fun. Ugh. There's no way Clarice is watching this. That looked like a cruise ship. Huh. Anakin! Darth Vader's in this! Guys! What? Alright, So the first two trailers definitely, like, set this tone, right? And I think this trailer does the same thing. I was hoping that this trailer would introduce us to our main characters a little bit more. It felt like another song tone trailer like the first two. Having said that, I think that the song and the tone is something that I'm interested in and that I'm enjoying. So I'm not, like, mad at that. I think it looks really fun. It looks good. I do like the CEO giving the interview where she's like, we're doing things differently now. And then it cuts to Lance Reddick being like, in that amazing voice that I just will never not hear as Silas from Horizon, both Horizons. Sorry if that's a spoiler for the second Horizon, where he's like, the thing has the T-virus. And you're like, are you doing anything differently? If you're using the same thing that caused all your problems the first time, are you really doing anything differently? Umbrella, I shake my finger at you. I'm excited for the show. I think that it has the potential to be very, very good. It has the potential to be very, very bad. It's a Netflix show, you never know. But I do like that it feels like it hews close to the aesthetics of the original, kind of the, like, barren, broken overworld with the clean, almost like Empire-like, interiors of Umbrella. I like that we're getting that disparity like we do in so many other Resident Evil properties. I like a lot of the creature designs. That giant grub, cool. Very curious to watch them fight that thing. And overall I'm into this. I think the show has potential. But again, this trailer does not feature any story content, doesn't really feature any character content. So I don't really get a sense of what is going on or who anyone is at this point. I think those two girls are probably Lance Reddick's daughters or adopted daughters in some way. That's about all I can do. I did like Lance Reddick smearing blood on his face. It almost looked like he was doing it to, like, shave, using blood as shaving cream, which is a very metal thought. But overall, I've got to say, like, these trailers have been enticing by lacking in things, right? But by not revealing too much, I feel like they've done a good job of making me wonder what the show will be about. And as someone who is just a lifelong fan of Resident Evil, I will check it out. I hope I'm not let down, but, you know, at the very least, I get to watch Lance Reddick for whatever 6 to 10 episodes it's going to be. So that'll make me happy, because he's just so good, and I could fall asleep to his voice, because it's good. It's a good voice. He's a talented man. If you like this video, like and subscribe to the channel. If you don't, hit that dislike button. Leave mean comments down below, because the algorithm god, she's hungry, and we've got to feed her. As always, you can follow me around the internet at NerdyNightly, and as always... I think I said as always twice, but whatever. Do something nerdy tonight.